Hello everyone, and welcome back to our Character Creator series in Godot 4. In the previous part, we defined our global script, and we created all of the collection arrays and variables within it. In this video, we will start creating our Character Creator Scene, which will be the first screen which we will see when we start the game, and it will allow us to create our player before spawning them into our world. It is in this scene where we will choose the player's body, hair, outfit, accessory, and colors for each, and we will also give the player a name. So let's go ahead and open up our project, and at the top, let's create a new scene with a Node2D node as its root node. Rename this node to Character Creator and save the scene in your Scenes folder. Now, we'll have to recreate our player skeleton just like we did in our player scene. So add a node to denote to the scene and rename it to skeleton. Then, for each skeleton part, add a node to denote followed by a sprite to denote as its child. Rename each of these parts to represent the feature that you want to have, so body, hair, outfit, and accessory. We did this in the player scene, but instead of renaming the sprite to denote, we're just going to rename the node to denote that holds the sprite to denote. Just like we did with our player, we will also add a default sprite to each sprite to denote and crop it out to our 8 frames on the horizontal and vertical axes. Now, let's scale up our skeleton and position it to be more in the center of the screen. I'm going to scale my skeleton up to 5 and position it to 570 pixels on the position properties x-axis and 120 on the y-axis. Let's give our screen a bit of a background color. So above your skeleton node, add a new coloric node. This will create a rectangle which we can color in. We want this coloric node to be full screen, so change its size to the size of your screen. You might wonder why we aren't adding our coloric node to the scene via a canvas layer node, and this is because if we add the coloric node to a canvas layer node, it will be treated as a UI component, which will always be drawn in front of our player's skeleton. We want our player to show on top of the background, so we won't add it to a canvas item. Then we'll change its color. Let's make it a light blue color. Okay, with our base setup created, we can go ahead and create the logic, which will allow us to select and update the sprites and colors for each feature. So, to each Node2D node within your skeleton node, attach a script and save it in your scripts folder. Also attach a script to your root node, since we'll also need to set our player's name. Let's start with our body script. We'll need to get a reference to our sprite2D node within our body node, so that we can update the sprite's texture property. We'll then also need to create a variable that will store our array keys, which are the identifiers of our body sprites and colors, which we added in our global script. Then we'll need to create two new variables, which will keep track of the current selected body sprite and color. With these identifiers created, we'll then create a new function which will populate our body keys arrays with the keys from our global bodies collection array, which contains all the body sprites. This will allow us to iterate through the different body options in our character creator. Then, with our body keys populated, we'll create another function that will update our sprite node's texture to reflect the selected key. We'll also set the sprite's modulate value based on the current color index. If we were to load our game, these sprites will show the first values of our global arrays, so the first body and the first skin tone. In the next part, when we add our UI, we will filter through the different options, and we'll also be able to change the texture and modulate values based on the next index in the array. We'll have to call both of these functions in our built-in ready function so that we can set up the keys and update the sprite to its initial state. Let's do the same for our hair, but instead of directly setting its texture and modulate, we'll first have to check if no hair is selected so that we can remove the texture completely. Then we'll do the same for our outfit. And then also for our accessory. For this, we'll also need to keep the null value in mind. Finally, we'll have to set the value for our player name in our root script. Since we don't have a text box yet, we'll simply just define a variable that will hold the value for our player name. With that done, we'll have to do one more thing, and that is to set our character creator scene as the scene that should run when we start the game. Open up your project settings and navigate to Application Run and change the main scene to your character creator scene. Now if you run your scene, your skeleton should spawn with the default sprites, which is the first value in your arrays that you created in your global script. So your first body value, your first hair value, your first skin color value, your first outfit value, etc. In the next video, we will create our UI, which will allow us to filter through our features. That's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.